like to know, what are the incentives that are being thought about strategically to get the private sector back reinvesting in British business, particularly when we see things like venture capitalists spending most of their money abroad?
Because the banking system has frozen up and it's not a very good mechanism for transmitting interest rate cuts into the economy. So you have to turn, as America is doing, as Germany is doing, France is doing, China is doing, to government taking responsibility for stimulating some activity in the economy. And so we have perhaps 40 billion of public investment this year. So you're advancing the building of schools and of hospitals and of transport programs and of rail. We've just announced a big railway investment. And that's a means by which we can kickstart the economy. The second thing, of course, we can do is give people incentives to make it easier for them and more profitable for them to invest. And that's why we're taking measures. That document you have on the table, Real Help for the Southeast Now, goes through all the different things we're trying to do to help business, to give it the means by which it can invest in the future, and if necessary, to bypass the banking system to enable people to have the resources they need to invest. Thank you for being with us today. It's been a pleasure for all of us, not only to be at this event, but to have visits in all different parts of the region. And let me, on your behalf, thank John Denham for chairing this event today. Thank you, John.
Thank you.
We are taking whatever action is necessary to make sure that people who are worried about their homes, people who are worried about their jobs, and people who are worried about their businesses have the security that they need for the future. And of course, we had to stop the banks from collapse, which happened in October, and would have been far worse if we had not taken action. At the same time, we've tried to get monetary and fiscal stimulus to the economy. That's cutting interest rates and giving real help to businesses now. The challenge that we're facing is the challenge that's faced in every country, and that is to make sure that the banks can start lending again to the people of this country, to businesses and to homeowners. And what we've announced today in the case of Northern Rock is that 14 million or so more money will be available for mortgage lending.